In this problem, we've got a proof that's been partially constructed. There are there's one blank here in the statements. There are three reasons that we have to fill in and any lines that we use. This is a proof of, to try to prove that two triangles are congruent. So we need to be thinking about our triangle congruence properties or triangle congruence theorems. There are four that we're concerned about here. One is SSS. That stands for side, side, side. If all the sides of two triangles are congruent to each other, then the triangles are congruent. So that proves triangle congruence. Side, angle, side. So if you've got two sides with an angle sandwiched in between them, same sides and same angles in both triangles, that, then the two triangles are congruent. Likewise, if you've got two angles with a side congruent in between them, that works. And also angle, angle, side. So two angles and then a side, but not in between. So those are four ways that triangles can be proved congruent. What we're going to try to do is see if we can make this stuff match up to one of these ideas. With any proof, I think it's really good idea to add to the diagram to make everything visual for yourself, and then try to walk through it with your own reasoning before you look at the formal reasoning below. So let's just mark what we know here. It says given EF is congruent to GF. So EF is here and GF is here. So those two sides are the same. And then it says DF is congruent to HF. So here's DF and here's HF. So that's the given information. It looks like we have two sides that are congruent, which is not enough. None of these just have two sides. If you're going to have two sides, you need to have an angle as well. Luckily for us, we do have an angle. And that's because here, these two are vertical angles. You see how these lines cross each other in an X shape? That means this angle and this angle are congruent. And if you look down at the proof now, you see they noticed that too. So we're on the right track. And now if you look at this, we've got a side, an angle, and a side up down here, and the same side, angle, and side here. So it looks like we're looking at side, angle, side as our reason. So let's look at the proof now and see what we need to fill in. Number one says EF is congruent to GF. What's the reason? Well, that's just given. So that's easy enough to fill in. And then number two says DF is congruent to blank because of given. Well, that's right up here. DF is congruent to HF. So that's easy enough to fill in as well. Then it says angle DFE is congruent to angle HFG. So DFE, okay, so that's this angle right here. And HFG, that's this angle right here. So that's referring to this pair of vertical angles. So the reason they're congruent is because they are vertical angles. So I'll just write a shorthand here for vertical angles. And then finally, we can say that triangle DEF is congruent to triangle HGF, and it's because we have side, angle, side. So we'll just mark down side, angle, side. And in this case, I think we need to indicate the lines that we used here because we need to indicate the lines where we showed that each of the sides and the angles were congruent. And that's all three of the previous lines. So you'd put 1, 2, and 3 in here. So that is a little bit of work with a proof about triangle congruence.